Hi, I'm Rob, and in this Gems of War video, I'm going to show you a rather awesome team you can use for this. Weirwoods, a faction assault, no mythic required. And I'll show a few different alternative ways to go about it if you're missing one of the troops. First things first though, you can pop to the shop, grab yourself a tier 1 if you need to. Remember, if your horde level in Weirwoods is level 100 or above, you will already have a potion of enchantment stored, so no need to actually buy one. Unless you want to buy some more tiers, in which case you need to buy them in order. And the Beastly Claw is at tier 4. Let's take a look at it. Does magic plus 2 damage to the first two enemies, boosted by allied beasts and summoner beast. So not too bad. Damage to the first two enemies. Quite often the second one could be stealthy, so a good way of hitting them. And as a summon as well, so yeah, actually not too bad. And has leaf as one of its upgrades, which is a leaf storm, which helps it get charged quicker. So yeah, not awesome, but not too shabby. Right, let's take a look at this team. I've shown a double Tesla team before, but I've never actually shown what to do if you've only got one Tesla. If you've got two Teslas, just pop the second Tesla in where the chariot is and have an absolute ball. But Tesla does 8 true scatter damage boosted by all ally and enemy armor. So the higher we can keep the enemy's armor, and the higher we can keep ours, or make ours and increase it and things like that, the more damage she's going to do. And she's absolutely lethal in delves because she basically scales in power with the enemy. As the enemy gets more power, it actually works against them because their armor goes up. She just does more and more damage. She's absolutely awesome. So the way you can go about it is to actually just increase the armor of the team, and therefore Tesla's armor, or Tesla's power rather, goes absolutely through the roof. The Shield of Urskaya, absolutely fantastic for this. Give an ally magic plus 1 armor boosted by all enemy attack. So the higher the enemy, again, the more this works. It actually works better on the more difficult delves, it's just crazy. Then Enrage and a barrier them. So we cast that on Tesla, and if you've got it upgraded, you also get Shielding, which is a barrier, which means you get 2 barriers for the price of 1, because we'll get 1 on who we cast it on, and we get a barrier automatically. Holus and Astra, really good for this. All human allies start with 50% mana, which is a Tesla, and Holus and Astra herself, and give magic plus 1 life and armor to all allies. Create a Lightstorm and enchant all humans. So if Tesla wasn't ready to go, she soon will be, because she's a human as well. The Chariot, we can chip in with this if we need to as well. We get multiple benefits from this. Grant a random status effect to a random ally when an ally casts a spell. So that could be enchant, it could be cleanse, it could be barrier, loads of different things. Really cool. And it gives magic plus 1 armor to allies with a 7% chance of an extra turn for each green gem on the board. So again, the armor increase is only going to increase Tesla's power. If you don't have the Chariot, there are definitely some other options. Let's take a look at what we can do. You want to keep it as a sort of true damage team if you're going to chip in with troops that do extra damage to complement. Oh, Tesla. Crimson Bat would be a good choice. Magic plus 1 true damage to all enemies. What else we got? Marilith's a good quick mana generator, but not essential for this. Queen Bee, always good. Cleanse on 4 matches. 9 green and 9 brown, bunch of true scatter damage, chance of an extra turn. The green is going to feed back into Queen Bee, the brown will charge up the shield, so that is a really good way to go about it as well. Nice compliment to Tesla there. Like I say, 2 Teslas if you got it, work really well. Foxfire King, 50% chance to inflict Fairy Fire on a random enemy when matching red gems. You'll do that when charging Tesla. And Fairy Fire is going to give 50% extra damage on the harder levels when the damage is huge. That's going to be absolutely mad. And you can cast that first option on the spell to get some true damage to all enemies as well. So lots of different options with this. Vanoxia, again, green and blue, really good. The green will feed back into Vanoxia. The blue will feed into Tesla and do true damage to all enemies as well. So yeah, lots of really good options if you don't have the Chariot. But let's take a look at the banner for this. I'm going to go for plus 2 brown, plus 1 blue, minus 1 purple Kraken banner from Blackhawk. Going to be in Geomancer class for this. Really, really good class. Gain 1 life for each brown ally is just minimal, but okay. Reduce damage from skulls by 50%. Really good. Really important to keep our armor as high as possible to increase and keep Tesla's damage high. Wall Construct, start with 50% mana. That is the hero. And we can have stuff like Impact. Anti-Magic Sphere is good. Tactician is great. Rock Solid, really important to get a barrier. Keeps our, again, our hero protected, therefore keeping Tesla's damage high. Can have a tree of knowledge, can have that. Gain enchant when matching green gems, totally useful. Do that to get Holy Saint Astra charged and a fortitude. Right, so let's dive in and have a few battles. Let me do a few ones on this lower level, and we'll jump forward and see how it handles the hard delves. Like at first, when we're going to wipe out the enemy straight away, no need to charge up the shield. The boost is 343 on this. So it's going to be affected by the enemy stats. The higher the enemy stats, the more damage output you're going to get. Obviously, a lower level player than mine won't get as big a boost as that because my armor on my troops is higher. You can chuck on Medals of Guard to increase the armor of all your team as well to increase the damage output. See, no need to actually cast this, but let's do it just to show the effect. Like right now, the boost on Tesla is plus 349. So we can cast this. And the boost is up to 447. So that was a really good boost for just something which was almost effectively free. It's just 6 mana, hardly anything. We got the potion of enchantment anyway. And we're good to go next round anyway. So we'll just take them out and finish off. No need to get that boost, but good to show the effect. Right, let's just whiz through these last few battles and I'll jump into the delve itself. Level 500. Show how we go about it from there. I'll put a link in the description below for the 2 Tesla team, in case people are unfamiliar with it. Really good fun team. Let's just do these last two battles. They won't take long. Looking for blue and red at the start. Let's just take anything because the potion of enchantment means we're ready next round anyway. And get this last level done. And we'll jump into the delve. Level 500. There we go. Kaboosh them all out of there. Right, so I've jumped into the Weirwoods. In the faction itself, on level 500. My horde level is quite high on this, so that does affect it as well, but the biggest effect is by the enemy. The higher stats the enemy has, the more angry Tesla gets, and she just ramps up the power on the voltage and just frazzles them into oblivion, basically. So same team, same thing, but the enemy stats are higher, therefore the boost on Tesla is going to be higher. So let's start up and let's see how much damage he's going to do right off the bat. So the enemy's got quite a lot of armor. Look, 260 on average, 260 something. So the boost is already plus 699. Now, I haven't actually done anything to this team. That extra power, which has come from the battle we saw just a moment ago, is got from the enemy, basically. So this will be the same. Even if your stats aren't as high as mine, even if you're a newer player, you're still going to get an absolute mega boost on that power. So Tesla's ready next round anyway, so we've got that boost. We want to get it a bit more, though, so we can charge up the Shield of Askaya first. Remember, this is boosted again by the enemy. The better the enemy are, the higher a damage we get. So let's cast this on Tesla. We've got a couple of barriers. We've now got a boost of 829. Let's make sure we got enough. Let's do this as well. Boost is plus 70. We did get an extra turn, so now the boost is 930. Let's cast Holy Saint Astra just for fun. What have we got now? Plus 1036. So didn't need to do that because we're still going to have to cast twice anyway. It's actually quicker to just cast Tesla twice. It was just a little bit fun just to show how much of a boost we can get just by casting the other troops just one time each. Yeah, we still need one cheeky mana from somewhere. So yeah, massive, massive overkill on the second cast. So quite often you just charge Tesla twice. We'll vary upon your magic level. You'll have to figure out what the best way is to go about that yourself. Let's go down the bottom path. So we'll grab ourselves some red. Like if you do some quick calculations, if you get like 3, 6, 9, 12, 1,200, so it's roughly 1,250 odd. So basically that is not quite enough right now. 737, although that is the boost, but the initial damage is really low, like 8. That's not quite enough to actually get it done in a single cast, or being done in two casts. So if we cast this first, we get the initial boost. Now, this is why you save Hodis and Astra. You cast Tesla first. There's the first lot of damage. But now we cast Hodis and Astra, and we enchant Tesla, making it quicker for her to get charged, because she's got the enchantment. And that's it. Done. Ready to go. Bang. See you later. On your bikes. Get on your tricycles. On your pogo sticks. Play your didgeridoos. What am I talking about? I have no idea, but they're gone. Next up. So yeah, when you're going to cast two of the armor boosters back to back, save Hodis and Astra, because you want to cast Tesla first, basically. Right, so, well, we can't say no to these four matches, because that'll just be plain wrong. 955 is the boost, so all we've got to do is get a second charge for Tesla and we are good to go. So we cast Hodis and Astra, get Tesla enchanted, go about getting our mana, and it will not take long at all. Even if there was no blue and red on the screen, you can just cast this on Tesla, make sure she's got a barrier. Or any troop, really, because it's important to keep as many troops buried as you can. Took a couple of hits there, but we've still got a boost of 1,154 there. Absolutely nuts. Nuts. Yeah, so I think I actually said something wrong maybe a second ago. I said to cast the Shield of the Sky onto Tesla. I think she already had a barrier. I mean, we got a barrier at the start anyway because of the benefits that I've got to this particular faction, but cast on anybody that hasn't got a barrier, because Tesla is boosted by all ally and enemy armor, so keeping all your team safe benefits this. So let's do this. Might as well do it on ourselves. We get enraged. Boost is 952. Let's cast Hodis and Astra. Don't need an extra boost. We just collect now for Tesla. See if we get any red or blue anywhere. Come on. There we go. And kaboosh them all out of there. Really, really easy. And the cool thing about the chariot is, and those sort of troops is, every time you cast a spell, you get a random status effect, which is surprisingly useful sometimes. It's a nice start, but we're going to get a potion of explosion, which is going to change things. So you can cast that now, if we get an extra turn. Happy days. If we don't, so what? We've still got a mega boost now of 1,180. Cast Hodis and Astra to get the enchant. Tesla lost her barrier, so we can cast this on Tesla to get a barrier back. And get our armor, get our boost in safety. What's our damage now, look? 1,491. Woof. So, I don't actually want to get that in the ideal world. If there was a brown match, I'd get brown to get a barrier, so the enemy then takes that. But I might as well take that, because I hit softer than them. So basically, less armor is reduced from the total that is going to affect Tesla's spell. Plus 1,449. That is a mega kaboosh. Frazzled into oblivion. Is that the last? Oh, it was the last one. See, it's so easy with her. It's just nuts. You don't actually realize you're on the last level sometimes when you're just going through it on autopilot. But there it is. A really mega easy single Tesla team. To whiz through the weirwoods. If you enjoyed this video, found anything about it useful or helpful, be really cool if you bash that like and subscribe button. It really does help. But most of all, thanks for watching. I'll catch you again next time. Bye for now.